Welcome to module 3 of design of machine elements. We will move to the design of keys and couplings, under which we'll be covering. So we'll see what are these keys actually. So key is a piece of steel inserted between the shaft and a hub or a boss of the pulley to connect these together in order to prevent the relative motion between them. So this is the one thing very much important. We need to prevent the relative motion in order to connect the shaft to a flange or a hub or nothing but a pulley or a gear. Okay. So in order to connect that, we need a mechanical member which will provide a motion which will be transferring the motion from the shaft to the driving shaft to the hub, okay, or nothing but a gear or a pulley. Okay, so it is always inserted parallel to the axis of the shaft. Keys are used as temporary fastening and are subjected to considerable crushing and shearing stresses. So we'll see type of keys. So there are two main classifications: light and heavy duty keys. Sunk keys, square, rectangular, gib head, feather and woodruff keys are sunk keys, light duty keys. Next is saddle keys. Keyway in the hub only in key has a curvature of the shaft. Third is the tangent keys. Okay, so fourth is the round keys and last one is the splines. These are the type of keys which we have. So you can see that. So light and medium duty keys figure I have shown here. So the heavy duty keys are round keys, birth keys, Kennedy keys, and we'll see one by one what are these actually. Sunk keys. Sunk keys provided half in the keyways of the shaft and half in the keyways of the hub or a pulley or a gear. Okay, the sunk keys are of the first. And we'll see the square key. Okay, square key is also a sunk key, so it is commonly used for power transmission. Has equal keyway depths in shaft and hub. So it is for the light duty applications. Width is 1/4 of the diameter, and thickness and height is also 1/4 of the diameter. Coming to the woodruff key. For lightly loaded applications, and it is easy to assemble and disassemble. So woodruff key is easy to assemble and disassemble. It has a circular groove in the shaft and holds it in the position. So it is applications are in automotive and machine tools. So you can see here woodruff keys as shown in the sketch, and in the saddle key and friction keys, key is given a concave shape to match the shaft radius. So you only on the key you have a curvature which matches the curvature of the shaft, and you don't have any key seat in the shaft in this case. So usually it is a tapered to for the torque time. Okay, next is the feather key. It is a sunk key of uniform cross section. Next is the design of sunk key. So sunk key, as I explained, half a portion of it will be in the shaft, half portion will be in the hub, so or in the pulley. So torque transmitted by the shaft is given by T is equal to load into the radius, or nothing but a D by 2, or you can rewrite that F is equal to 2T divided by D, where F is the tangential force, D is the diameter of the shaft, B is the width of the key, and L we will be using as a length. Okay, then key failure due to compressive or bearing stresses. So compressive stress on one side of the key or a side of the shaft key seat can be calculated using this equation. So area in compression in this case is L into H by 2. Our equation for the stress, we sigma b1 is equal to f by a, or f by a is l h by 2. f is known to us 2t by d. Wherever that, we just substitute the values of f, or rearranging the equation for the torque, t is equal to sigma b1 l h d by 4, equation number 4.4b in page number 62 in Balveer Reddy and Mahadevan design data handbook. To avoid the failures, obviously it has to be less than the allowable stresses, sigma d and sigma tau 1 is equal to less than the allowable stress. This is a check we need to do in the problem as well. So effect of key ways for the sum key equation is also used sometimes. So we can have a effect of key way ke is equal to 1 minus 0.2b divided by d minus 1.1h divided by d. So this is the equation sometimes we use in the problem to compensate for the key ways in the sum key.